Good morning children, welcome to math class. How you all? I hope you are good. So in previous session we had discussed about the relationship between radius and diameter. Yes, am I correct children? Yes, how can we say that the relationship between and radius and diameter?
First, as this is circle, this is circle, so midpoint we call this as center. And the distance from center to outline we call this as radius. And if we draw another radius, now this becomes diameter. Okay children, so that means we can say that diameter is twice the radius. So this is radius and this is radius. If we join two radii, we'll get one diameter. So diameter is twice the radius. And we can say that, so is this total is diameter, no children? So you can observe only half of the diameter. Yes, is this radius or not? Yes, radius is half of the diameter. So we can say that diameter is equal to 2 into radius. Okay, diameter is equal to 2 into radius. And radius is equal to radius. So here the total diameter given, how we have to find radius children? If we divide the diameter by 2, we'll get radius children. Okay, radius is equal to diameter by 2. So here you can identify diameter is twice the radius. Diameter is twice the radius and radius is half of the diameter. Okay, this is diameter and half of the diameter is radius. You can remember this too. So next you are going to learn about new topic, concentric circle. Okay, so once everyone say along with me, concentric circles. So what are concentric circles we will learn in this class? Concentric circles. So concentric circles means the circle with same center and different radii we call concentric circles. Okay, the circles with same center and different radii are called concentric circles. So first everyone open page number 18 children. Yes, open page number 18. 1.19 have to check. Draw two circles using a compass. The circle should be of different sizes, but both circles should have the same center. Okay, how we have to draw this circle children? You have to draw the two circles with different sizes, but the center is same. So for example children, so this is one circle. Okay, this is one circle and this is another circle. So but the center of the two circles, but the center of the two circles is same. So how I draw this circle? So first I place compass at this point, I draw first circle, and again just I change the length and I draw another circle. Okay, is it clear? So here I drawn with using my hands, but how we have to draw children? You have to take the compass and place it on the paper, and first we have to draw one smaller circle. Okay, so and then you have to place the metal tip at the same point, and just you have to change the length. Just you have to increase the length and you have to draw one more circle. Okay, so now we can see that the center of the two circles is same. Am I correct children? So this is the center of the circle and this is only the center of the circle. But now you can observe the radius children. Yes, what is the radius of the circle? Yes, this is the radius of the first circle, and we can say that this is the radius of the second circle. So this is first circle and this is second circle. Here the center, same center but different radii. So these circles are called concentric circles. Okay, is it clear children? So what are concentric circles? Concentric circles with same center.
So these two are having same center but different radius. Yes, we know that what means radius? The distance from center to the outline. So this is center of the second circle and this is outline. Here the radius of these two circles having same center but different radius, children. This is the radius of the first circle and this is the radius of the second circle. So these type of circles are called concentric circles. Okay, these type of circles are called concentric circles. Here also you can check, children. So the center of two circles is same. So but coming to radius are different. Okay, coming to radius, the radius of the two circles are different. So these type of circles are called concentric circles. Yes. So everyone draw this circle like this, children. Okay, everyone draw this circle like this. Do these circles meet at any point? Yes, these two circles meet at any point, children. At any point these two circles touch? No. So here you have to pick option 1. Okay, page number 18, you have to pick option 1. And here given definition of concentric circles, children. Circles with same center and different radii are called concentric circles. And some examples of concentric circles are given. Yes, here you can check, children. So is this example of concentric circle or not? Yes, how we have to identify, children? So concentric circles have same center. Yes, this red, this is the center. And if you find the radius of these circles are different. And like that, here given one Pokalam, children. So here also you can check, this is example of concentric circle. And here you can check the slice of onion. This is also example of concentric circles. So just you have to observe, children. Concentric circles means same center and different radius. Okay, two circles having same center and different radius, these are called concentric circles. Next, 1.20. Using a compass, draw a clock on the wall with two concentric circles. Draw the hour hand as the radius of inner circle and the minute hand as the radius of outer circle. So here what you have to do, children? Using a compass to draw a clock on the wall. Okay, here this is one of children. So here you have to draw a clock on the wall with two concentric circles. So you have to draw the two concentric circles like this and then draw the hour hand. Yes, we know the hands of the clock, hour hand and minute hand. So draw the hour hand as radius of inner circle and the minute hand as the radius of outer circle. Okay, here you can check, children. So here I have drawn two concentric circles. Okay, here I have drawn two concentric circles. So now write numbers, children. Here we have to draw clock now. 3, 9. So write 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11. So here I drawn clock. So now we have to draw the hand. So how we have to draw? Here given already instructions, children. Draw the hour hand as the radius of inner circle. Okay, draw the hour hand as radius of inner circle. So this is inner circle and this is outer circle, children. Okay, this is inner circle and this is outer circle. So here we have to draw the hour hand. Okay, here what we have to draw? Our hand. So we know that, children, our hand we have to draw here. Okay, have to draw our hand. Okay, our hand is thicker, children. So you have to draw our hand as the radius of inner circle and the minute hand as radius of outer circle. Minute hand as the radius of outer circle. Yes. So you have to draw radius of outer circle. So for here I am drawing, children. Okay. So this is the radius of the outer circle. Yes, children. What means radius? The distance from center to the outline. So this is the outline of the outer circle now. So you have to draw minute hand like this. Okay, is it clear, everyone, children? So here you have to draw the clock like this. So once again I am repeating how we have to draw. So first you have to draw two concentric circles, and then you have to draw our hand as the radius of inner circle. So this is inner circle, you have to draw radius, and for outer circles you have to draw minute hand. So we know that the radius means the distance between the center of the circle to the outline. So here I draw the line from center to the outline. So everyone draw the clock here like this. Okay, here you have to draw. So now open companion, children. Open companion. Companion page number 9. Tick the pictures that show concentric circles. Okay, here what you have to do? Tick the pictures that show concentric circles. Okay, here given totally 6 pictures, children. So in these 6 pictures, what are the pictures that shows concentric circles? You have to tick it. Yes, tick the first one, children. Yes, is this concentric circle? So how we have to identify concentric circles or not? Yes, you have to check, children. These circles are having same center and different radius. Yes, the first one, this is having, these circles having same center and different radius. So this is concentric circle. Yes, you have to tick the first one, children. Yes, everyone tick the first one. And you can check the second one, children. Yes, the second one is concentric circle. The second circle is like this. So the second circle is like this. So is this, these all circles having same center, children? Here these circles are met each other. So these are not concentric circles. So no need to tick it. And next, coming to the next one, this is third one. Okay, these circles are having same center, children. No, these are also not having same center. So this is also not correct. Next, observe the fourth one, children. Yes, we can say that this is concentric circles. Okay, this is concentric circles. These are having same center and different radius. So tick it, everyone. Next, last one. So here you can check, children. These circles are having same center and different radius or not? Yes, yes, in the inner one, inner circle like this, and this is outer circles. Okay, so these are having same center and different radius or not? Yes, you can tick this. And the last one, so this is the last one. So these two circles having same center and different radius. Am I correct or not? Yes, children, so these circles are also having same center and different radius. You have to tick it, first one, fourth one, and last, these two also concentric circles. Okay, just you have to identify the circles having same center or not. And if it is the circles having same center means, then you have to check the circles having different radius. Okay, the circles having different radius, then we can say that those are concentric circles. Next, open studio, children. Open studio. Page number 20. Things I have learned. Okay, things I have learned. We are given one mind map. Shapes. So first, in this chapter, we have discussed about polygons. Yes, what are polygons? Polygon is closed shape and formed by only straight lines. Yes, we are given closed shapes that are formed by using dash lines are called polygons. Okay, polygons are formed by straight lines or curved lines, children. Only straight line. So in this blank you have to write stripe. STRAIGHT. You have to write stripe in this blank. And then examples of polygon. So here you have to write the examples of polygon, children. So what are the examples of polygons? You have to write any 4. Next. So coming to the circle. A circle is a closed shape formed using a dash line. Yes, children, circle is formed by only curved lines. You have to write curve. Mark the parts of the circle. So here in this circle, everyone label the Here given already we have to mark the parts of the circle. So what is radius and what is diameter and what is chord? We have to identify and mark the parts of the circle. Yes. So this is about today's class, children. So everyone complete this mind map. So in mind map, what you have to do? So in polygon side, just you have to write the examples of polygons. We have already discussed the examples of polygons. You have to write the names. And coming to the circle side, here given circle and here given parts also. Just you have to mark the parts of the circle. This is your homework. Thank you. Have a nice day.